Shalom, Boker Tov to everyone. Good morning. Wednesday, May 13th. We're now on the other side of Lag BaOmer. Continue with some morning Torah. And I want to talk about there's a double portion this week, Bahara and Bechukotai. Bechukotai literally means it's usually translated, if you follow my laws. Bechukotai, you follow my laws. But Bechukotai, my laws, it says Bechukotai Telechu, which really means if you walk in my laws. And Rabbi Levi Yitzhak Abir Deitcheve, Hasidic rabbi of a couple of years ago, says it specifically the language is when you follow my laws. I understand that's what it means. But why is it walk in your laws? Why should we walk in God's laws? And he responds, because basically the laws of the Torah, what we call the mitzvot, the commandments of the Torah, are a way to walk. I mean, by the way, this is the word root of halacha. Halacha, Jewish law, is also halach. Lehalech is to walk, also the same verb. So it's not just a do this because, God wants you to, but do this because you will walk. And he explains walking is a spiritual walking. That when you, as you fulfill commandments, as you follow the laws of the Torah, you will advance from one level to the next level spiritually. And so therefore he kind of reframes, because a lot of Bechukotai, if you read it, is filled with things called the blessings and the curses. It says, if you do these following laws and you follow my laws, etc., then good things will happen to you. And if you don't do the things, bad things will happen to you. And that has its own theological problems, and perhaps we'll cover them in the next Devar Torah, in the next couple of days, the whole issue of reward and punishment. But he focuses just on that phrase, saying, look, if you follow the laws, you will walk, or you will walk in my way. And I want to just say that this is one of the ways I personally reframe what a mitzvah is, right? So mitzvah literally means commandment. Mitzvah, when you hear it used in our kind of general language amongst the Jewish community, usually translates as a good deed, which are two important things, not necessarily contradictions, but they're not the same. A mitzvah literally means that there's someone who's, a commandment means someone's commanding, right? I do the mitzvah of Shabbat, I honor Shabbat, I honor my parents, I love my neighbors myself, not just because it's a good thing to do, although I think that's true, but it's required. There is something, in this case, God, the Torah, commanding me to do it. So if I feel like it, don't feel like that, you guys do it. That's the commandment of mitzvah. Good deed interpretation, also powerful, means I do it because it has some kind of intrinsic value, positive, intrinsic, hopefully moral value, that adds something to my life. But again, that they both serve different purposes, but some people might not believe that God actually commands. And others, what do you do? Is keeping Shabbat a good deed in the terms of good? Now, we can see all reasons why Shabbat, I think Shabbat brings a lot to the world, taking rest, letting the world rest. We don't own the world. But lighting Hanukkah candles, is it a good deed? It's a meaningful deed. It's a deed, I think, that's historically rich. I think it adds something to your life. But is it good in the sense don't place a stumbling block before the blind? Like, that seems to be good in a sense of morally good. So it's actually an interesting question. Neither of those translations often meet the contemporary seeker, the commanding God, or the good deed. They do at times. So what's the one that I prefer? The one I like is mitzvah. This is offered by the Hasidic mystic rabbis a couple of years ago. Very strong Hasidic teaching. Mitzvah has the same Hebrew letters in it, tzav and evet, and as tzavta. Tzavta is an Aramaic word, tzavta, similar to word tzevet. Those that work at Jewish camps know the term tzevet. Tzevet is the staff at our JCC camp. They say, hey, all the tzevet, come together. It's all the counselors, and they all call it tzevet. Tzevet means like a group of people that are attached together. It really kind of means attached, connected. So mitzvah can mean commandment, or good deed, or it could mean tzavta. Mitzvah is connection. I'm thinking, okay. Well, spiritually, these rabbis teach, a mitzvah is an opportunity for a human being to connect with God, connect with the Torah, connect to other human beings, connect to one's own neshama, to one's own soul. When you look at a mitzvah like that, basically means every time a mitzvah comes up in the world, the sun rises, you have opportunity to pray in the morning, the chance to, food is presented before you, the chance to offer a blessing. A person is, before an elderly person, you shall rise, you shall honor, honoring the elderly. It's not that you're doing it just because it's good or just because you feel commanded, if you don't, you'll be punished. You do it because this is gonna open you up to connection, spiritual connection. And it's a way of looking at life as opportunities to move beyond what seems like normal, chol, ordinary, and all of a sudden turn your living room, your office, which you're both right now, I guess, you know, whatever you're experiencing, into a moment of divine connection. Tzavta. Mitzvah as spiritual opportunity, as I'm walking through life looking for moments to see holiness. That's another way to look at mitzvah, and it's one that I prefer. So when the Torah says, "Im bechukotai telechu," if my laws telechu, you will follow, but you will walk, means that you have an opportunity when you're doing my laws, whatever the Torah teaches us, not just to do it because you feel you have to, or as consequences. Not do it because it's a good deed, although that's nice too. But do it because if you walk in these laws, the world opens up as a place of spirituality, a place of opportunity, a place of glory, a place of spiritual connection. You know, there's old jokes as someone's, you know, people come to shul to pray to God, and Goldstein comes to shul in order to talk with Goldberg. You know, that joke means you come to shul to connect with people, to connect with history, to connect with who you are, and connect with the divine. That's also what mitzvot are about. Im b'chukotah te'elecho. We have the opportunity every day, every moment, to connect to tzavta, to connect what is greater. And that's what a mitzvah can do too. Boker tov. Have a sweet day with many spiritual connections, please God, in this day. Shalom.